Welcome to the fourth session of this fifth module. In this module, majorly we will discuss about the other type of non-conventional energy sources, and this energy sources is also termed as the indirect type of solar energy, that is nothing but biomass or bioenergy. That is what we are going to discuss it. Basically, this biomass is nothing but a biomass contains a stored chemical energy. Basically, why this biomass we always call it as the indirect type of solar energy is only because, irrespective of the plants, they always grow up by utilizing the solar energy. That means they will prepare their food using the photosynthesis process. By the process of photosynthesis, they will prepare their food with the use of sunlight or the solar energy. Unless the solar energy, the plants will not grow. So their growth or their food is nothing but the solar energy. So that is why the solar energy, indirect type of energy, is nothing but the biomass. That is what we popularly call it. Now, basically, this biomass energy stores the chemical energy. Chemical energy is nothing but anything. You say, for example, petroleum products, it is nothing but a chemical energy. The food which we have it, whether it may be rice or vegetables or spinaches or fruits, it is all called as the chemical energy. The same way, they will also prepare their food in the form of chemical energy by using the sunlight or the sun. Plants produce biomass through photosynthesis process. Photo is nothing but a Greek word. Actually, I just shall go in deeper. It's a different details when we talk about the photosynthesis. I'll go in deeper. So they just prepare their food through photosynthesis process. Biomass can be burnt directly for heat or converted to renewable liquid and gaseous fuels through various processes. Actually, in the next slide, I will show you the different ways of harnessing this biomass. Basically, this biomass can be directly burnt in our domestic purposes, for heating or cooking purposes. Cooking, it was in olden days, even in the rural side. Nowadays, they will use the wood, burning the wood directly in order to take the heat from the biomass, or it may be converted into a liquid form, or it may also be converted into gaseous form. Gaseous fuels also, we can in terms of liquid fuels as well as the gaseous fuels, we can convert that. That includes a lot of procedures. I just shall come to that later on. The most electricity generated from the biomass is produced by direct combustion. The electric generation, basically this biomass energy sources, more than the electricity generation, we will use it for our domestic purposes itself. More than industrial or for the electrical generation, we will use it as a fuel in the engines. We use it in the domestic purposes. Okay, now this, most of this power generation from the biomass, it is by the direct combustion, not by converting it to liquid or gaseous state. This steam flows over a series of turbine blades, causing them to rotate. Okay, the rotation of the turbine drives the generator, producing it. Is the same thing in my dream. So it's a story repeating, that's it. Now, biomass is an organic matter. Okay, organic matter, it is only because it is having a chemical energy and it is happening naturally by use of solar energy. Okay, now, anything that is alive or was a short time ago, that can be used as an energy source. Examples of biomass includes wood, crops, seaweed and animal waste. Biomass gets its energy from the sun and it is a renewable energy source. Why we categorize this biomass under the section of non-conventional energy sources, it is only because whatever the energy that we get it from the biomass, it is non-exhaustible. That means if you cut a tree, I shall cut the branches of the tree, it grows once again. It grows once again. That is the beauty of that. But it may take slow time but still it grows. That is there, isn't it? You cut a tree, once again it grows. It takes more time. It may take around 3 years, 4 years, 10 years, but still it grows. That is the point. That may be one of the disadvantage also, but that is the point which makes this energy source to come under the category of non-conventional energy sources or renewable energy sources. Okay, now examples we have. Now, for example, we can give it anything, even the crop waste, even the cow dung also. They will make it into the plates and they will dry it and they will burn it. Anything from the plants or any sticks or any saw wood, sawdust, anything will be used for the burning of this. That is the beauty of this biomass. Only thing is, it should be in a dry. That's it. Only thing is, it should be dry. Now this figure, the flowchart, will tells you the different ways of harnessing it. Now let me go one by one. If you consider this carefully, if you have a biomass feedstock, it can be converted into three stages. The first stage is the thermochemical process, where the combustion is being done directly. The hot gases which are coming out will be used for the steam process, heat electricity. Okay, now I'm just talking about only the one which we are going to burn it directly, and then gases which are coming out will be treated, and that gases will be used to generate the steam and use that steam for the electricity production. Now if you take a gasification is nothing but converting the biomass into gaseous fuel. Now even in converting this gaseous fuel, there are two types. One is a low energy gas and the other one is a medium energy gas. I don't want to go deeper, but still I'll tell you. If you take this is a wood, okay. Now what I will do it is, this wood will also have certain hydrocarbons. So what I'll do it is, I will burn this. I mean to say that I will heat this. No, so not burning. I will heat this in the absence of oxygen. So please be careful here, my friends. I'm taking some biomass and I'm heating it to a very high temperature. I'm heating it to a very high temperature in the absence of oxygen. When I don't have an oxygen, what happens? Does it burn? No, it doesn't burn. So what happens? The cellular chains or the cellulose which are present in the wood will be broken down. They will break down the cellulose chains and they will liberate some gas. That gas, the quality may be low energy gas or it may be the high energy gas, or the, I'm sorry, medium energy gas. Are you getting my point? So this is the point. So what we will do it is, the outcome of this gas, we will use it for the steam, for generation of electricity, or maybe we use it in internal combustion engines. You can also use it in internal combustion engine. When it comes to the medium energy gas, this medium energy gas, once again, it can be used for steam generation, it can be used for IC engines, or it can also be used for fuel gases for methane. Methane will be an effective fuel, the gaseous fuel. And then it can also sink with the liquids, methanol, gasoline. Okay, now this is the gasification. Now whatever these hot gases, low energy gases, medium energy gases, these are all nothing but an intermediate processes. Now if you go for a pyrolysis is nothing but, my dear friends, what happens is, pyrolysis is a process of breaking down of this biomass into small particles and heating them with a limited amount of oxygen. That is what point to be noted. I will break down, I will cut this, I will chop these biomass into smaller particles, and then I will heat them to a very high temperature with a limited amount of oxygen or the air. That releases three byproducts. One is a medium energy gas, similar to this gasification only. Then there will be a char, that means a charcoal, And then we will also have a hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are nothing but CH. Hydro means H and carbon means C. Any hydrocarbon is a good fuel. Is it here? Now you can see once again medium gases can be used for the multi-purposes. And then the char is an end product that can be used in domestic purposes in order to store some temporary amount of heat. Char is of not a high level grade of energy which can be extracted. And then the hydrocarbons, this is wonderful. These hydrocarbons use as a fuel oil and distillates. Use this as the distillates and fuel oils. Is it clear? Now we will also have the last one, which is nothing but the liquefaction. Liquefaction is nothing but converting the biomass into a liquid state. Say for example, if you take vegetable oils, vegetable oil is also a fuel. Okay, you will also have a sunflower oil. It's a fuel, it burns, but we use it for cooking purpose, that is secondary. Okay, there are different liquefaction processes are also there. You will take the human manure. The liquefaction also includes, actually one interesting thing is, we will take a solid waste, human manure, animal manure, we will take cow dung, everything we will put into there, and we will convert that into the other form of energy, that is the liquefaction. You might be remembering the ethanol. Ethanol which have been achievable by the molasses which are coming out from the sugar cane. From the sugar cane we can also extract ethanol. Ethanol C2H5OH is an ethanol. Okay. Ethanol and methanol can be extracted from the biomass. I will go in deeper how we are going to extract it. Liquefaction, then from the liquefaction we will get it as hydrocarbon liquid oils that can be used for the distillation purposes and fuel oil. These are all the final products. This is how we can extract or harness the biomass energy conversion system. This is a brief one. In depth I just shall discuss it later. The most interesting thing is that photosynthesis. To be frank, before I get into photosynthesis, whatever the photosynthesis equations or the process that we are going to study, it is not an 100% agreed one. It is only because a photosynthesis process which takes place in the leaves, in the trees. Okay, in the trees, it always takes place in the leaves. Leaves are the places, we are also called the leaves of the plants as a kitchen of the plants. Because the food is always been prepared there. So the chemical reaction which takes place, or the chemical energy which is generated in the leaf, is a very complex equations. It's a complex reactions that nobody could able to deal with it. The only some assumptions, with a few assumptions or some expectations which has been proved nearly to the photosynthesis equations has been given by the scientists or the researchers. Is it clear? So that is the complexity between with the photosynthesis. Basically this photo means light, synthesis means preparation. Synthesis means preparation, photo means light. Preparation of the food using the light is called as a photosynthesis. Is it clear? It's a Greek word. It is photo means light and synthesis means preparation. So this photosynthesis is nothing but the preparation of the food or the preparation of the chemical energy using the light is nothing but photosynthesis. This photosynthesis is a process used by plants and other organisms to convert light energy into chemical energy. That is a beautiful, except the plants, no other elements or no other reactions, no other artificial method by which we can effectively convert this light into this chemical energy. Okay, through cellular respiration. cellular respiration means even on our skin, our skin requires the sun, which generates vitamin D. How does it generate vitamin D? Once again, it is a complex. It's a difficult reaction. So whenever there exists the solar radiations which falls onto our skin, there generates a vitamin D chemical. So that is also a chemical reaction. Is it clear? It's a gift of God. Okay. Can later be relieved. So cellular respiration, this is what we call it as a cellular respiration, can later be released to fuel the organism's metabolic activities. Every human being, every animal will have their own. Any living things will always have a metabolic activity. If I eat 100 grams of rice, I have my own metabolic reactions, metabolic habits. The same 100 grams, if somebody XYZ have it, his metabolism rate will be a different one. So that depends very. So that is why one plant grows of certain height in 1 year, the same plant, the other plant takes 10 years to grow in that height. So the other plant takes only 6 months to grow. So it depends. Is it clear? Now, in general, the photosynthesis is as follows. It takes carbon dioxide and water and then the energy. The energy is nothing but light in the chlorophyll. With the use of a chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is nothing but what we see it as a green color one on the leaves. Even if you take this leaves and if you squeeze it like this, your hand will become green. Whatever that, it is nothing but a chlorophyll. I have not mentioned here, but still it will be there. Okay. It takes the carbon dioxide and it takes the water in the presence of sunlight in chlorophyll. It releases C6H12O6, it is nothing but a sugar or a sucrose. Sucrose will always have a sugar content. And then it releases the oxygen and some water and energy from the sunlight. It takes carbon dioxide, water and energy from sunlight, produces glucose and oxygen. And small part of, heat will also be released in only few cases, not in all the cases. So this is the beauty. Now the point to be noted over here is, it is taking the carbon dioxide as a raw material for the preparation of the food. That is a plus point for all the animals, including human beings. And it is releasing oxygen. Nowadays, I was just talking on the other day, people are going for oxygen cylinders after cutting down the trees. Till now, the people are not aware how much the oxygen is being required. Simply they will cut the road, trees. It is only, I'm not blaming any particular human being. For all the in general, we want a road, so we will cut thousands of trees. We want some building to come up, so we will cut so much of trees. But we don't grow the trees. Why it is happening is the deficiency of oxygen. But still, it is naturally happening now because of this pandemic situation. We are running behind of the oxygen cylinders. At least now we have to realize, being a responsible, not as a citizen of India, at least a responsible human beings of the earth, responsible animals, intelligent animal of earth, we have to grow more and more plants so that we will get more of oxygen. Now I'll just like and define the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a process of preparing the food by the plantations by taking carbon dioxide, water as the raw materials in the presence of chlorophyll and the sunlight. It prepares its food, giving out a sucrose and sugar or a sucrose and oxygen. By balancing the equations, we have taken 6CO2 plus 6H2O will give rise to 6C6 and H12 and O6. That is nothing but the sucrose, or what we call it as a glucose. And in few textbooks, they have also mentioned it as 6 of CH2O twice. It is only because if you multiply, then we will give it as C6H12O6. It is a complex chemical reaction. Okay, now I just shall define a photosynthesis is a process of preparing the food, or we can also say it as is a process of converting the sunlight into solar energy into chemical energy by the plants. By the plants, considering carbon dioxide and water as the raw materials in the chlorophyll by the use of sunlight giving out the sugar and oxygen, releasing the oxygen to the environment. So this is what we call it as the photosynthesis process. Is it clear? Now this photosynthesis is comprised of two stages. One is a light reaction and the other one is a dark reaction. Dark reaction, or we also call it as a light independent. Light reaction and dark reaction. Now please be careful, whenever the photosynthesis question is being asked, you have to write the definition, then you have to write the equation, and then you have to answer the two stages of the photosynthesis. One is a light reaction and the other one is a dark reaction. Light reaction can also be called as a light dependent reaction, and dark reaction is also called as light independent reactions. Okay, and it has been explained by Jones and Jones, the two people with same names. The light dependent reaction uses energy captured from the sunlight by the chloroplasts in the plant leaves to produce the supply of electrons from the light independent reactions, whereas the light independent reaction use energy from the supply of electrons to reduce carbon dioxide to produce the glucose. In the light reaction, what happens? As the name itself indicates, the light reaction takes place during the daytime and the dark reaction takes place during the night times. In the light reaction, what happens? It produces the electrons for the light dependent reactions, whereas the light independent reactions takes out these electrons and reduces carbon dioxide into glucose. The resulting glucose is being converted into adenosine triphosphate, that is ADP, that is what we call it as adenosine triphosphate, through a cellular respiration. Through the cellular respiration, it will generate that. Then, in addition to glucose, this reaction produces, I will explain this light and dark reaction once again in the next slide. In addition to glucose, this reaction produces oxygen that is released by the plants into the atmosphere. So that is the major plus point of this photosynthesis. It is convenient to divide the photosynthetic process in plants into four stages. Two steps, that is light reaction and dark reaction, it is different. Four stages it just takes place, each occurring in a defined area of the chloroplast. Chloroplast or the chlorophyll is nothing but the green portion of the leaves. It just takes place. Okay, the first stage is absorption of the light. In the first stage, what happens? If you have the leaves over here, so what it will do, it is, it will absorb the solar radiations. That is the first thing. Second is electron transport leading to the reduction of NADP and NADPH. NADP is nothing but nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, whereas H stands for the phosphate one. Okay, NADP plus to NADPH, and this is what happens because of the electron transportation. And the third stage is generation of ATP. ATP is nothing but adenosine triphosphate. And the fourth one is conversion of carbon dioxide into carbohydrates. This is the process what we call it as the carbon fixation. Three majorly questions often, if I am setting any question papers, I always concentrate on these three. One is a light reaction, one is a dark reaction, and the other one is carbon fixation. What do you mean by this carbon fixation? During the photosynthesis process, in the fourth stage of the photosynthesis, the adenosine triphosphate, which has been generated by the cellular respiration, convert the carbon dioxide into the carbohydrates and releases the oxygen. So this process is called as a carbon fixation. This is an important point, my dear friends. So this is what we call it as carbon fixation. The carbohydrates are nothing but the sugar of the sucrose. Thus, this is an important one. Thus, the photosynthesis consists in building up of a simple carbohydrate such as the sugar or etc. in the green leaf in the presence of sunlight. The oxygen liberated is from water molecules and not from the carbon dioxide. This process is also comes under the definition of carbon fixation or carbon assimilation. Is it clear? So I will reframe the definition for the carbon assimilation or the carbon fixation. During the photosynthesis process and the fourth stage of the on the fourth stage of photosynthesis, the ATP will convert the carbon dioxide which is available in the nature and the water. Using this water and carbon dioxide, this raw materials will be converted into sugar or a sucrose or a carbohydrates and releasing the oxygen. And this release of this oxygen is from the splitting up of water molecules, but not splitting up of carbon dioxide. We are not splitting up of carbon dioxide, but we are splitting up of water molecules. And whenever we split this water molecules, the releasing oxygen will be liberated. So that is what we call it as carbon fixation. That means carbon will be a fixed one along with the oxygen. That is, carbon dioxide will be fixed. That will be used for generation of carbohydrates. Whereas water molecules will be splitted up and this oxygen will be liberated. And H will be hydrogen molecules will be used in the production of the food, that is carbohydrates. Okay. Now this can also be photosynthesis is essentially a reduction and an oxygen oxidation process. Reduction means we are reducing the water molecules and we are oxidation is taking place with the carbon dioxide. That is why from the beginning itself I'm just telling you this photosynthesis is a bit complicated reaction which is taking place at that level. Okay. Now if you consider the processes of photosynthesis take place in main two steps, that is what light reaction and the dark reaction. Splitting up of water molecules into hydrogen and water under the influence of chlorophyll and sunlight. This phase reaction is called as the light reaction. I will explain this in better way. During the daytime, the sunlight is being used in splitting up of water molecules into hydrogen and water, hydrogen and oxygen, using the movement of the electrons. By the movement of electrons and cellular respiration, by using the sunlight, movement of electrons and cellulose respiration makes the water molecules to split into hydrogen and oxygen, which takes place by the influence of chlorophyll. This phase of reaction takes place only during the daytime, which is called as a light reaction. Okay. In this phase of reaction, light absorbed by the chlorophyll causes photolysis of water. What do you mean by photolysis? Photo, that is a light which is making the water molecules to split and oxygen escapes and hydrogen is being transferred into some other compound, that is HCO thrice or HCO six times it will be converted into an unknown compound, whereas oxygen will try to escape out. Whenever the sunlight which comes over there, it leads to photolysis process which splits into hydrogen and oxygen. Oxygen will try to escape out, it will escape out and hydrogen will be converted along with carbon dioxide to an unknown compound which you call it as H2CO into six times, which comes to C6H12O6. Okay, this is what about the light reaction. Thus, the solar energy is being converted into potential chemical energy. Now, if you come to the dark, the second phase, the hydrogen is being transferred from this unknown compound to carbon dioxide. See, this is the beauty. That is what I was thinking. What happens in the light reaction? Hydrogen and water molecules will be splitted using sunlight and chlorophyll. Oxygen will try escape out to the atmosphere. Whereas what happens? The hydrogen molecule will form to be an unknown compound. This unknown compound will mix with carbon dioxide to form carbohydrates. And this, in the second stage, what happens? This hydrogen mixes with carbon dioxide and forms the sugar or a starch. So this formation will always take place in the night times, and night times annadikinna it doesn't requires any sunlight. So it is called as dark reaction and not requiring the sunlight. Then I'll quickly go with the different conditions necessary for the photosynthesis. What are the conditions necessary? If the photosynthesis has to occur, what are the conditions which are required? By the way itself, before I go into that, we can discuss here. One will be light, the other one will be carbon dioxide, and the other one will be water, and it may be the other thing is also sunlight, okay, or it may be a temperature. Now if you take the first one, light, one of the important inputs for the biomass production is the intensity of solar radiation. Only a part of this energy, 40 to 45% of the solar radiation. If this is a leaf, if the solar radiations which are coming over and falling onto this, if 100 radiations are falling onto this, only 40 to 45% of this energy will be utilized for the use. The appropriate wavelength falls between the range of 400 to 700 angstroms. To produce photosynthesis, the plants use radiations between 400 to 700 angstroms. Only a part of this energy is actually used for the photosynthesis. This range of light is called as a photosynthetically active radiation, which we call it as a PAR, photosynthetically active radiations. And the upper limit of the photosynthesis efficiency is about 5%. That is the first thing. Second thing is carbon dioxide concentration. Carbon dioxide is the primary raw material for photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide constitutes about 0.03% of atmosphere. Nowadays, no need to worry about carbon dioxide. You will get, wherever you go, you will get plenty of carbon dioxide because of the pollution. Okay. So, basically, a normal pure air will always have 0.03% of carbon dioxide in the air. However, if carbon dioxide availability is increased artificially, linear increase in the yield of several crops up to a limit have been observed. Hence, one of the method of increasing biomass by supplying additional carbon dioxide to the plants. The main source of carbon dioxide are animal respiration, combustion of fuel, and the major sources is a decay of organic matters by bacteria. By decay of bacteria also we will get it. Now, one interesting thing is, whether you want it or not, I would like to tell you, even idli, dosa, whatever the things, we just grind it and keep it over here, and we will mix up with some soda and salt. In the morning, you can see a bulged portion. That means it has undergo some digestion and it has released carbon dioxide. The point to be noted. Is it clear? So, okay, then the ocean also is an important source of carbon dioxide, much of which comes from photosynthesis of marine plants, respiration of marine plants, and animal releases carbon dioxide into water. That is the one thing. And that is the reason why even you might have seen in few cases in agricultural lands, they will burn something, the straw, woods and all those things, they will burn it in order to increase carbon dioxide percentage. Third and the last one is temperature. Photosynthesis is restricted to the temperature range which can be tolerated by proteins. That is 0 to 60 degree temperature is a nominal one. If it reaches more than that, then they will get into burns. Although photochemical part is not affected by temperature, but biochemical part controlled by enzymes is highly sensitive to the temperature. These are all the important factors which influence greatly the photosynthesis effect. Now, my dear friends, the photosynthesis, definitely there will be one question on this, because based on this photosynthesis, the plantations will be there. When the plantations are there, then definitely we will get biomass energy conversion systems.